Hey, what's going on everybody? Welcome to today's tech tip where I'm going to show you how to install Windows 10 using a USB drive. This video will be helpful for those who would like to see step-by-step instructions on how to install Windows 10 either on a brand new PC or someone who already has a computer and want to perform clean install or reinstall Windows 10. So let's begin. If you have already purchased your Windows 10 copy, there's a chance that you may get your copy of Windows 10 installation media on a USB device. If that is the case, feel free to skip to the section where I actually show you how to install Windows 10 using a USB drive. But if you already have your Windows 10 installed on an older computer, and if you want to install Windows 10 on a new computer using a USB drive, or perhaps you want to do a clean install or reinstall Windows 10 on the same computer using a USB drive, then you got to watch this video completely as I'll show you how to use a USB drive and make that as a bootable drive and copy Windows 10 installation media into it to install Windows 10 on a PC. Soon after the installation of Windows 10, you need to activate your Windows 10 copy, and for that, you need to have your license key with you. Like I said, if you already have a bootable USB drive that came with your purchased copy of Windows 10 installation media, you can skip to the next section where I'll show you how to install Windows 10 using a USB drive. Otherwise, you need a USB drive to copy the installation media of Windows 10, and you also need another computer to download the media creation tool from Microsoft, which would help us to copy the installation media of Windows 10 on a USB drive and to make that a bootable drive. Microsoft recommends using an 8GB USB drive, but I'll be using a 32GB USB drive. Make sure you don't have any data on this drive, or if you have data on this drive, it is important that you back up your data because the media creation tool will format and wipe out all the data that you have on the USB drive to copy the installation media. The last thing, you need an internet connection because after the installation of Windows 10, you need to download some drivers for the devices of your computer. You also need an internet connection to download the media creation tool to prepare the USB drive for copying the Windows 10 installation media and to make it a bootable USB drive. Depending on the speed of your internet connection, it may take some time to download the setup files. Alright, the first step, we will download the media creation tool. I have another laptop where I have Windows 10 already installed, and I'm going to plug my 32GB USB drive into this laptop. I will open up the browser and navigate to Google search. I will type media creation tool Windows 10 and press enter. I will click on the first link that says download Windows 10 disk image from Microsoft. Scroll down to the section where it says create Windows 10 installation media and click on download tool now. Once it is downloaded, I will open up the setup file media creation tool by clicking on it. When it opens up, it will come up with the wizard and says getting a few things ready. When it is ready, it will show you the license agreement terms. Simply click on accept. Again, it will say getting a few things ready. Once it is done, it will prompt you what you want to do. You now have two options, which are upgrade this PC now or create installation media. We don't want to upgrade the PC, so I will click on create installation media, USB flash drive, DVD or ISO file for another PC because we are performing an installation from scratch. I will click next. On the next screen, it will ask you to select your language, edition and architecture. You can leave the option use the recommended options for this PC checked, and the option selected for language, edition and architecture would also match for another PC where you will install Windows 10. Otherwise, you can uncheck use the recommended options for this PC and manually select your language, edition, and architecture. Regarding the architecture, it is based on your processor, whether it is a 32-bit processor or 64-bit processor. All new PCs come with a 64-bit processor. It is very rare these days to use a PC with 32-bit processor. I will leave the option use the recommended options for this PC checked and click next. Now in the choose which media to use screen, you have two options. In my case, I will select USB flash drive as this is where we are going to copy our Windows 10 installation media and make that USB drive bootable. You also have ISO file as an option which allows you to download the ISO file and burn it into a DVD drive or use a third-party tool called Rufus to copy the ISO file into a USB drive and make it a bootable drive. I will keep USB flash drive selected and click next. In the select a USB flash drive screen, I will select my USB drive, which is F drive. If you don't see your USB drive or just plugged in your USB drive to the PC, click on refresh drive list to see your drive and click next. And it will start downloading Windows 10. It will show you a nice little progress bar that shows the percent completed for downloading Windows 10. The time it takes to download this depends on the speed of your internet. So I'll speed up this video. Now you can see the download has completed and the setup screen will verify the download and it will start copying the Windows 10 installation media to the USB drive. When it completes, click finish to close the media creation tool window. Alright, the USB drive is now a bootable drive and contains Windows 10 installation media. I will eject this drive and remove it from this PC. Now I will plug this USB drive into another PC where I would like to install Windows 10. While powering on this PC, you need to go into BIOS and change the boot order. To go into the BIOS, you may need to press one of the function keys. It can be F1, F2, F11 or F12. And in this screenshot, you can see it is delete button to go into the BIOS screen. It totally depends on the PC and sometimes you may need to refer to the manual of your PC. On some PCs, you don't need to go into BIOS. Instead, there are certain function keys or keys that you need to press to simply change the boot order directly. In most cases, it would be function key F9 or F10. Once you make the changes in your BIOS where you would make the USB drive as the first boot device, again, you need to press one of the function keys such as F10, and if your BIOS supports mouse, you can navigate using your mouse to save the changes. After selecting the USB drive to boot with, the Windows 10 setup will prompt to press any key to boot from CD or DVD. I will simply press a key. Now the Windows logo shows up and the Windows 10 setup screen shows up. In the Windows setup screen, select language to install, time and currency format, keyboard or input method. For the language to install, I will keep English United States selected. For the time and currency format, I will select English, India. For the keyboard or input method, I will select English, India. I will click next and I'll click on install now. It says setup is starting. In the activate Windows screen, it will ask us to type the license key of Windows 10 that you have purchased and this key will be used to activate Windows 10. For this demonstration, I will click on I don't have a product key and I can still specify the license key and activate Windows 10 after its installation. In the next screen, select the operating system you want to install. You need to select the appropriate edition that you have purchased. The license key that I have is for Windows 10 Pro and I'll select that. Click next. In the license terms screen, simply select I accept the license terms and click next. Now it will ask which type of installation do you want. There are two options, upgrade and custom. The option upgrade will upgrade from the previous Windows version to Windows 10 and it is not what we are doing for this demonstration. The second option, custom, is what we will select which will perform a fresh install of Windows 10. I will select Custom. It says where do you want to install Windows. If this is an existing PC, you may see multiple disks and partitions, and if you are reinstalling Windows, any version of Windows for that matter, or performing a clean install, then you need to be careful when selecting the correct drive which already has the Windows partition on it, because that is where you will install or reinstall Windows on it. If you accidentally select a wrong drive, then Windows will be installed on the wrong drive and you will lose any existing data on that drive. One way to verify that is to use Disk Management tool in Windows. You need to do this before you start Windows 10 installation. So you will right click on the Start menu and select Disk Management, or type Disk Management in the search box next to the Start menu. After opening the Disk Management tool, you can see multiple disks. One easy way to find out the Windows drive is to look at the volume that says boot. So I will expand the status column. In my case, it is OS C drive, which is disk 1 and partition 3. On this PC where I'm installing Windows 10, I have a single drive but multiple partitions on it. So for the sake of making it simple, I will delete all the partitions. Now I have a single drive which is 60 GB in space. So I will select that drive and click Next. Now it will start installing the Windows, copying the files and getting them ready. This would take some time to complete. I will speed this up. When it is done, it will automatically restart the PC. Now that Windows has been installed on the drive that we selected, you can remove the USB drive attached to this PC. Otherwise, it may boot the PC from the USB drive again. We don't want that, so I will remove the USB drive. After the restart has been completed, the Windows setup will resume. It'll say getting ready for a while, but it will reboot one more time. It'll say just a moment for a few seconds and it will resume the setup again. First, it'll ask the region. I will keep India as the region selected and click on Yes. Now it will ask for the keyboard layout. I will keep the default keyboard layout, which is US, and click on Yes. If you want to add a second keyboard layout, you can add now by clicking Add Layout, but I'll click on Skip for the second keyboard layout. The next set of steps require internet connection. If you don't have internet connection, you can click on the link that says I don't have internet and continue with limited setup to complete the setup. But I have internet connection, so it has moved to account section where it asks how would you like to set up this computer. You can either set up the computer for personal use or for an organization. I will select set up this computer for personal use and click on Next. If you already used a Microsoft account to sign into your old Windows 10 computer, you can log into the new computer using the same Microsoft account and it will restore all the settings that you had on the old computer. The only downside is that you need to manually key in the license key of Windows 10 to activate it. But I don't have a Microsoft account and I typically log into my computer using a local account, so I will click on Offline Account to create local account. In the next screen, it asks you to sign in to use Microsoft Cloud apps and services such as OneDrive and other cloud apps. For this demonstration, I will click on Limited Experience. On this screen, type in the name of the person who is going to use the PC and it will create a local account on this PC. I will type in my name and click on Next. I will type the password for the local account and I'll confirm it again and click Next. Just in case if you forget your password, you can select 3 security questions from this list and it will help you to reset the password. So I'm going to fill all these 3 questions. Click Next. I'll select the second question. Click Next. And the last question. Click Next. on the privacy settings, I will uncheck all the default selections for things such as location, find my device, diagnostic data, inking and typing, tailored experience, advertising ID, but you can keep these settings on if you want to. I will click on accept. I will let Cortana provide personalized experience and suggestions, so I will click on accept. Once again, it will tell just a moment and tell hi to you. So it will finalize everything, and this will take a while depending on the speed of your computer. Now we have logged into the computer, and the computer will connect to the internet to download and install the required drivers for your computer. It will only install the standard driver from the Microsoft repository, but if your hardware components such as graphic card, network card, and display card needs third-party drivers, then you need to search them on the internet to download and install them. I'll click maybe later for Microsoft Edge. The last step is to activate your Windows 10 copy. I will right-click on the Start menu and I'll click on System. When the System window opens up, scroll down and click on Change Product Key or Upgrade Your Edition of Windows. You can see the activation status. It says Windows is not activated and it reports that no product key was found on your device. So click on Change Product Key and type in your product key, click next, and it will activate your Windows. So this is it. This is how you download and install Windows 10 using USB drive and media creation tool that we downloaded from Microsoft website. I hope this has been helpful to you. Please click the like and share buttons. Do support my channel for more videos like these.